great pleasure for you to be back here at Strathmore to be people who are successful business. For the people who are taking risks, what can you do to celebrate? Sometimes you celebrate countries, sometimes you celebrate criminals. SME is a very interesting technology. It's not occupying some space in the world. And many countries are paying attention to SMEs and how to promote them. For many countries, it's the heart of the economy, including some very successful countries like the US. The US is the largest economy in the world, but 90% one of the things I see as a mission is because of the biggest not just within your own business and social about your own business, but among yourself. That is where you are doing your own part and your own business. I want those of you where you are starting to see this, make that really true. How are you going to see it? Your bargaining position. Because the big boys are already organized. The Kenyans are still the factors. They only support the big boys. They support the SAP, but within the association, their place becomes smaller. So, what I would like to argue today is to really now, if you are organized, you will engage in a meaningful way in institutions like KRA. Because KRA, they are hungry for that. They are seeing the teachers on the streets, the nurses, all the men who are over there from the government. All of them are looking for you. Because you pay. And if you are not organized, they will come. They will come for you. And if you will see some of them will want back taxes, they think they are millions. Now you don't need to get into the country. So, you will be slapped very heavily. Organization, that is the institutions that is the The other advantage of organization is your linkages with multinational enterprises. Many of them are coming to tell you their steady line is out there with investments. Many of them are here actually already. I want just to give you an example of Talo. Talo is basically a contractor to the government to extract money. The way it doesn't come to Talo, it belongs to you and the government. Anything you need to hit the mining act, anything below 6 feet, not 6 feet. So that's the point that you are somebody to extract. Now, Talo is going to distribute so many contracts. Successfully pump that oil from the world. Big operation. Somebody has to provide certain services to the value chain. Now, the first thing that my national government partner will ask you is, are you ISO certified? How many of you are ISO certified? How many of you? So you cannot pass a plan. You are already blocked. The success of countries like Korea, Malaysia, Singapore, all the Southeast Asian countries has been promoted most of this through linkages with multinational enterprises. You instantly, by associating with these companies, by adopting their systems, you become multinationals in your own country. So, one of the things I would like to add to is really pay attention to what multinationals are doing. Remember, those multinationals are SMEs 30, 40 years ago, 30 years ago. Every business starts small. Even some of the companies you are buying today started small. Coke, for example, is this year 1.9 years old. Coca-Cola. But in the first year of operation, only sold 9 bottles. Only 9. You can guess how many servings they are giving today. You can guess. As wild as it gets. Come. You are the consumer, you are looking to serve. Today, Coke has 1.9 billion offerings daily. For 9. So you never know, one of you could be the next one coming out of training and you'll be starting to that is how it will be. But somebody must be the whole thing, and that is why it's very important. So, as a preliminary, one, you are the heart of every community, please raise your voice. You can only raise your voice if you are organized. You must come together. And then you must have that organization will allow you to link with the big boys. It's very difficult for a person to drive itself. It's very tough, very challenging. You must have a way of linking with the other big boys. And then you can move up to the big boys. The next message I wanted to to you is to think Africa. You know, we underestimate how Africa operates. For other people, they see problems, other people see opportunities. They send problems and they see opportunities. But let me give you some statistics about Africa, and if I think that this is more like for Africa. Africa is 64 countries. 1 billion people are empty, but it is the fastest growing. The average number of children per woman in Africa is 4. Okay? The highest country is Niger, 8. So West Africa is growing faster than East Africa population mass. But 75% of that population, that 1 billion, is below the age of 35, and they have access to technology, mobility, and mobility.
Toronto, you have a young population, very vibrant, okay, excited about new technology. Most of them are young technology. Their income is rising faster than most economies. 7 out of the top 10 fastest growing companies in the world are the most important. One of them is the fastest growing. In the next 5 years, the top 10 out of 10 will be in Africa. So, fastest growing, the current estimate for Africa's middle class is 300 million people. And what's the middle class? People who have at least an income of $1,000 per year. Most of them are Nigerians. Who are the beneficiaries of this Nigerian relations? Where are they passing? Most of them come from France. Are there things you guys can sell to Nigerians? Of course, yes. Why should they be going to Dubai? Because they own a business. They own a business. So that is why I say organizations become very critical. So that then, instead of them going to Dubai, they just pass to Dubai. Government looks at them negatively because of the contract charges. But that's a very small part of the population. If they can enter Dubai, and Dubai is the airport to get sentenced, they tell them, come and buy from us. Who are you? What are you? So sometimes we have nonsense about what Africa is. But I want you to start thinking seriously about Africa, even if it is small size. If you don't have that long-term vision, you will never grow. Because you get into a comfort zone. I can feed my children, I can take them to school, and I have my small pension, that is enough. As a business person, you owe it to the society, to employ more people, to create big companies that put Kenya on the map. If at least all of them will reach number 8, when this value can take things as national anthem to play, who are you? You saw them in Beijing the other day. Even though they never went to school, but they are global ambitions. They want to stand on a global podium and say, I'm a Kenyan. Now you are sitting here with all these degrees, with like a small business, and you can't even have African business. So I'm challenging you to think African. So that then, Kenya's national anthem will be played over like half in years to come. And then you say, yeah, we are reasonable, we are Kenyans, and we want to influence the world. Because if our wildlife, our elephant is to comes to celebrate it globally, what are people like you? What things? Because Kenya is being globally globalized by the now, others have come to help us out in the city of Israel. But we need to celebrate but with an African state. Now, Africa is too big for you initially. Begin with East Africa. Remember, the number one trading partner for Kenya and Uganda is Europe. European countries, one of the big countries. And one of number two, one now is Tanzania. Tanzania has a big demand. So, one Tanzania is a big demand. If there was peace in South Sudan, that could also be something big. And that is why it's happening to our president to continue to see in South Sudan. But that is a big demand as well. Our neighbor, Ethiopia, is also producing a big market. And the road is open up to Malo, voila, going 90 million people. So how many cakes? You just need to sell that half. 40 million cakes every day to Ethiopia. And voila. Even water in Somalia, companies like Coke never go out with an active today, they still have a plan to get it. Some of the guys who think long term, they say, okay, I can survive this, but after all, you still have your arm. That's not full of the cup. Yeah? So they will protect. That's why they never see that name, that carriage or whatever. Do you know that at Wilson Airport, the biggest operation is in Iraq? That's the biggest business in Wilson Airport. And where does it go? So, I mean, if somebody saw a problem, another one saw an opportunity. And they are trying. How they land without being shot, how they link with the one, it's perfect. How do you survive? That's very hard. So, those are the lessons you learn when you're dealing with very difficult conditions. Look at GPT. Many people are surprised by GPT. Water and they are in fact very bad. But you guys do have a problem with the opportunity. How many people? 3 billion people. Okay? Need mining operations and it does the result of them. But they are going to learn to small businesses, not that I have a while, until they get the right place. I don't want it to be. I want it to have an African strategy even in this year. Even when you are just in the road. Because that is means that in the next 10 years, you already have a roadmap for growth. And that creates an ambitious entrepreneur. So I want you to start thinking through, think of Uganda, think of the 20% of Kenya, have small operations, and you can have partnerships in every country. We are here, then remember EAC is already a custom zone. So there is already preparation for trade arrangements within the scheme and within the NASA and Africa. If I may say this for the European government, it's here. It's very big. I remember seeing a small, the guy runs a small lodge, somewhere around the the guy's a Dutch. He came on holiday here in Kenya and he's a plumber. He told his story. He's a plumber. He's a plumber in Belgium. Then he came here on holiday and then he said, this is very nice. So he started, he said, he brought his journey and just built a very small house along the coast. Now, when I saw the Christian service in Greg and the he has been this small hotel, I think he has only been to it. And he's now classified as a Christian. And who are his major clients? All these are kids. Where he came from, all these are kids are his clients. So he saw a lift built from a plumber, okay? And then now he has a Christian hotel. Happy and wonderful. I met him the other day, I was telling you, how he has the plumber package has been through for his baby, and he keeps expanding, he wants to move it to the first star, and he can see it. It is the best place for him to apply it. He is young, but how you are seeing this thing every day, and I tell you, and you are saying, God bless you. So, I want you to start thinking, Africa, Africa is perfect. And Africa is a large country. Remember, it is 4 times the size of the United States. 4 times as our country. If you want to, if you want to know how many countries you can fit in Africa, it's the US, it is China, the entire Western Europe, all of it. India, Japan, UK, France, Spain, Italy, and of course, it's starting with this point. If you look at, for example, arable land, the current estimate is that of the remaining arable land in Japan, 60% is just to come to Africa. It requires a decision. also push from other parts of the world to come and take them to the market. And you'll be watching these people that come and they will sell money. This is a problem. So, I want to conclude by giving you five mega things that you can do. As a business, you need to look at whatever you're making. If you are coming from micro to small, small to medium, how fast you make that decision, you have to prepare these five things. The first one is leadership and every business has to be leadership and management. It's good for the people to have to do it. It's good for the people to have to do it. Business is good for the people. Business is good for the people. Governance is about the structures you put in place to ensure success in your business. Sometimes you need it, but you don't have the governance structures. Like that in the event that you are not there that day, the business manager. The structures you put in place to ensure success. Governance also implies values. I don't want to be a person who says, you can't build your business on the basis of your values. You might get some temporary windfall, but those are things that you ask. If you build your people, the customers will have them. You know, many people are expecting to have all the people who must take care of their customers. It's not true. You are not driving the customers to take care of them. You must build your people. Motivated and committed to your job, to your plans, whether you are seeing them or not. You must empower them to make decisions on your behalf and do what they want. Motivate your staff. Please take care of them. Don't worry about the rest. You must be able to plan what you want to do. And you must have the best and carry on. Many businesses hear them. I always look at how you have the education. Many of you have been made to us of this. Now, how many hours did the day have you been doing? How many hours did you get to sleep when you get to the end? How many are you up? The other one working for us. Come on. gonna start up campus. How do you do? Many people now is to be normal to take this So when the money comes, you just look at it. Yes. But actually, the net comes, you are making less. So over time, over this year that we plan to see the health in 50 years, but the highest poverty rate in Kenya here is West Africa, most specifically. So how come people are being attacked for 50 years to have the first income? It's because they don't understand this account. They are running losses for 50 years. The same thing is being created to survive. Maybe. I think you are lost for 50 years, but these guys don't understand. And they plan this in, out, and they are not moving. Every year in the record, you see the next 2 months. Few before that, you see the report, the guys buy a house. You see the tax. Then the guy says, who pays you? But he has contracted it to 50. If the Athenians started using 40 for example, the ticket placement. Thank you. you are, moving backwards, how do I fix it? Build robust systems in every community. When a mayor has a critical basket of talent, the quality of people are so much more than the quality of the business. This is a great technology, but for heaven's sake, build robust systems. Now, based on the reason why I'm emphasizing systems is because the business growth is very important. Many family businesses typically when they run out of business, they can't without the business. So, what they do is that instead of the business is here, they're not the business. And that's why we have to pay our business. Businesses are not good to some business that is not the only way of confidence that something happens is. Then you can monitor the phone from a distance. How are you guys doing? How are you doing? I'm making a person. So, these are building systems, however simple it is, and it's just important. And above all, this technology is available. Let's take apps. There are so many apps. How many of you are using Google? So you have a taxi guy, you have a software, you also have a computer, so you sit to your taxi signal, and then the nearest taxi comes along. So I'm complicated. You can't believe it. But what's the value of Uber? Well, the whole time is now worth $50 billion. Besides a pay of duty. Use existing technology, and if you don't understand it, buy consultants, let somebody else use it. Tips people to help you get to the community. Because I will tell you, we are moving to a point where virtual reality can have a class for them. And in the next 2 to 3 years, 80% of this form will be. So, with the next 3 years, everybody might be able to have a smartphone. How are you going to link with somebody with a smartphone? If you are not on a technology platform, customers can be able to do it. You can do it. Please, build robust systems that allow you to keep the team without discipline and leverage. Number five is brand identity. A brand is a person. A brand is a person. So, please build your brand. But don't build it for it. Customers will ask you. So, they build money. Today, this is big time. So please keep your promise to your customers and this is done. So it ties up with what I say to you about the government. If you govern your company and you keep your promise to your customers and you do what you will always be in the same way. You might struggle literally to be stuck in. Thank you. therefore, it is not part of the process. Remember, there are also the things of the process. Let us see. Thank you.